after doing dance and fitness video reviews for almost 2 years now, I can't believe I haven't touched the most significant series in this genre, Just Dance. Well, that ends today when I go back and review Just Dance 2020 for the Nintendo Switch and literally everything else. And I mean literally, the game came out on the original Wii, for goodness sake. So, I decided to play this version and play it, 2 years after the fact. That's how on top of the ball I am. I'm going to be doing Wii Fit Plus soon, and I'm probably going to be doing, the home fitness game for the Wii 3 years from now. My name is Jack Jenkins, and welcome to my YouTube channel. I do videos and reviews on topics within the realm of self-improvement. Let's get started with the review of Just Dance 2020.
For self-improvement, crafts, and fitness games, go ahead and turn on YouTube and watch Jack.
As always, let me cover you my history with the series. I haven't played a Just Dance game in so long. The last time was, back in high school, back on the original Wii. I played games within the realm of Just Dance, such as Dance on Broadway and Baila Latino. Both of these reviews can be seen below. So, I was super excited. I left a little bit disappointed since the series, seems kind of stale, honestly, and hasn't changed within the past 10 years. First, let's get off to the most important part of these dancing games, the soundtrack. I love pop music and dance music. I haven't heard many of these songs before this game. The soundtrack contains 40 different songs, including massive hits at the time, such as Bad Guy by Billie Eilish and Seven Rings by Ariana Grande. Breakfast at Tiffany's and bottles of... I don't know the lyrics. The soundtrack for the 2020 version also includes a ton of foreign songs from Blackpink and 21. I like K-pop from like the 2006 middle school nerd perspective, because, before it became something for little girls, if it was for us nerds, we're always the cool. But, this new stuff is like aimed at a whole different audience, so I wasn't really that into it. It's great that, more diverse of artists are getting on this game, but I just wish there was some, older dance music from the 90s and 2000s. Here's the full set list for the game. If you like these songs, then you will enjoy the game. If not, you should skip it and you'll get the 2021 or, wait until 2022 comes out, which, since the video is recording, should be in like a few months only. I will say that the 40 songs are standard with this series. But I would just wish that they would up it to 50 if I was in charge. Have, say, like 10 retro tracks each game to make millennials like me happy. Now let's say you like these songs and pick them up. How do you play? Well, you do what the title says and just dance. Alright everybody, that's my review. Thank you. Like, share, subscribe to my friend Star. I'm joking. To hold the controller in your hand, you just put it in your hand, and then you follow the avatar and just dance. The closer you are to following the actions of the rhythm, you get a score from bad to perfect. These scores will fill up your meter and give you stars. Your goal is to get over 5 stars to become a superstar. The gameplay is standard and straightforward, but it is perfected over the years. All the jank is that's in like the previously mentioned games like Baila Latino or like Dance on Broadway is just completely gone. the Just Dance team has truly mastered the programming and the gameplay mechanics of mimicking the dancing with the phone or controller. That's right. If you don't have enough controllers, you can just use your phone. How great is that? That's such a cool idea. I mean, it's no wonder there really isn't any competition from these games, because, you know, let's be honest, they got this absolutely locked down. I have absolutely no complaints about the gameplay and experience no issues with the controller. Like I said, chef's kiss, they perfected the formula.
It's down the top, the bass split, the brass, the chub split, the tub. The fluke is a duke of soul, the red he can play.
If you get sick of playing the only 40 songs repeatedly, you can get Just Dance Unlimited. You get a free 30 days when buying the game, so that's what I did during my time. They have almost all the songs from the previous Just Dance games, and including exclusive ones. The Just Dance Unlimited has more retro tracks and classic songs, such as like the Monster Mash, the Monster Mash, and the Ghostbusters theme. I played both of these with my girl, and we just had a blast playing through, you know, the 500 plus catalog of songs.
I see a picture of me all the time. Stepping girl.
If you get Just Dance, then get an unlimited subscription. It's just $25 per year, which is great if you have played the game a lot. My one issue is that the music is super censored. That like any words such as like damn or hell are just removed. The game is E10 plus, but I would just be like, hey, just push it for a T rating, you know, just so you can have less censorship. You know, you should be able to say bitch. Bitch is fine. You can say that on the radio. You know, I get it. It's just 3 years. But I'm not sure why games need to have such a small gap for each rating, too. Speaking of that, because like 10, 13, 3 years. I get there's a lot of maturity there, but why does there need to be two separate ratings? Whatever. Besides just dancing, you can play the kids mode, which is pretty much Just Dance Kids for the Wii. You got kid-friendly songs and unlicensed music. Fun stuff for the whole family. Then you got the All-Star Mode, which I was excited about. The All-Star Mode can be thought of as the story mode for the game.
So let me come and explore you.
Where you have to play songs from all the Just Dance games to rescue dancers and get them on your little party bus. Playing through All-Star Modes unlock a new secret piece of music. That all sounds exciting, right? Well, the story mode and Smurf's dance party takes longer to beat, and that takes 30 minutes. You play through 9 songs, unlock High Hopes by Panic at the Disco. It's just a terrible song, by the way. I gotta have high hope for living. That was a garbage song. I almost said the F word. But yeah, it's just a terrible song. And then that's it. That's just absolutely terrible. Not only that, but you have to have Just Dance Unlimited to even play All-Star Mode, which is one of the 3 main game modes. If you don't, then you're just stuck with just these 2 dance modes, just kids mode, or you can just dance yourself, and that's it. What a waste of a mode. It should have you play like 5 songs from each of the Just Dance games, including like Just Dance Kids, or like the Just Dance Disney games, or even like, hey, Dance on Broadway. Do that. That counts as a Just Dance game. Or maybe it'll be even better if it goes through like the evolution of popular music from like the 1900s on to 2020. Those 2 ideas are just great. And the songs they pick aren't even that good. 2 or 3 of them are like Katy Perry songs. A fourth of your main mode is just 1 artist. It's a massive disappointment for me and someone who played like the original Wii games, where it feels like they actually put in some effort into creating a well-crafted series. Now it just feels like they're, hey, it's a new Just Dance. Blah. Other than that short mode, you can complete the daily challenges that get you coins. You can then spend those coins on unlocking icons and stickers. You can play online in dance competitions, which is just a really cool and awesome idea. Other than that, you just got the songs that'll keep you busy. I should say that the unlimited subscription is an incredible idea, but the servers are just garbage. You can see from my footage that the film is running at a super low resolution and it pauses frequently. I've been kicked out of a song that has almost ended more than 10 times, which is incredibly frustrating. You know, I have absolutely zero problem streaming with YouTube or Netflix at, you know, 1080p or 4K. I can do that easily. So why can't I do Just Dance at like 480p? You know, the issues could be remedied on the Ubisoft side by allowing you to download the video, but no, that's just way too much effort for that team to do. Like I said, this game feels like it's kind of already a dead series. Ubisoft is great at like beating a dead horse, you know? Assassin's Creed is still pumping out, and that game came out when I was like in junior high. My overall thoughts are mixed. I love the idea of the series, but it seems that they just get lazier and lazier every year. It's to the point where everything, including the menu interface, is reused from last year's version. I understand that they are pumping this game out every single year, so it can be hard to get new ideas and to just get everything fleshed out. I don't blame the studio a single bit, but I blame the Ubisoft executives for beating a franchise with fantastic potential to death. Trust me, I'm a software developer. I guarantee you they're struggling over there. They need to take like a year's break to focus solely on building out a better foundation with more modes, more different activities, a story mode, all that, and then start releasing more yearly until they can break again and flesh out. That's what they did with the Assassin's Creed series. They should do it with this series. Until then, it just feels like they're still trying to beat this dead horse, hoping that it'll spit gold, but instead, it just spills blood. I'm going to continue with the Just Dance series on my channel. I plan to start playing them every year when they come out as complete fitness game reviews. I'll play 2021 and maybe the first one during my budget fitness game month. You know, those two can take up as two slots out of the four I usually do. I'm hoping to plow through, you know, all of those at like 2x a year, so by the time I'm like 40, I'll be out of Just Dance games to play. In the meantime, you can catch my other videos on fitness challenges, self-improvement tasks, and product reviews, and just so much more. If you guys have any ideas on videos you want to see, then please leave a comment in the message below. I will do pretty much any video idea commented. Like my videos and subscribe to the channel to see more. Follow me on Twitter at TrueJackJenk. Lastly, have a fantastic day, everyone. All you guys are just so incredibly amazing. Take it easy. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be